Well, actually, yes. I mean, as you say, it was done at the tail end of the last government, and unfortunately I wasn't involved in that at all. And it was a step in the right direction, but it was really a very small step in my view. It was a passing nod to something that was going to come later. And there'd been lots of debate about it, and the bits actually in it that we've actually used side blocking is not actually through that act at all. It's through another legislation thing we put through. And the big cap, which I think is what you're really referring to, I have to say I'm disappointed with it. It's a small step in the education process of the whole piracy debate. And it's a good step, and we should definitely do it. But it is frustrating. I mean, we haven't been able to agree from the rights holders, the ISPs, the government. They've been going around in circle about what information can be given out and what was repealed and what can be done and what will the government contribute. In America, they have a different ISP contribution than we have in this country, and that's been a bit of a debate. And I have to say that, in my personal opinion, is that the ISPs are dragging their heels. They really don't want it. I've met with the ISPs on this, and what they're telling me is that it will be another year. Once it's agreed, it'll be a year before it's in because they've got to write the programs or whatever. Well, they could have started that 3 years ago and it could be ready now. And the reality is that, I'll take a bet with anyone in the audience, that it won't be in before July 2015. I'll have a £10 bet with anyone who wants it, because I just don't think I see the BPI here are very involved in the negotiations. And of course, they want it to happen, but I just don't think the ISPs are coming to the table quick enough. And there is a problem with government money, where it comes from and so on. And I think it's something that is a crying shame wasn't in earlier. I'm actually meeting with Google next week, and I'm writing a paper, not for the Prime Minister actually, but for Vince Cable on Google, and we'll certainly be putting recommendations like that into it. But when I was in America, they really don't like Google over there. I mean, I don't like the ISPs here, they don't like Google there. I made a favourable comment towards Google, and that was picked up by all the press, and it was, I think it was probably slightly misinterpreted, but I'm going to say something quite controversial here, which is, I mean, every debate you have always comes round to Google. Now, I would point out that Google aren't the ones making the illegal content, and they're not the ones using the illegal content. Yes, they're pointing people to it. Yes, they're taking some advertising revenues. I know we're going to talk about that in a minute. But at the end of the day, they're not the ones using it. Now, I'll use a good example. There's a band I'm involved with that released a CD in January. And they released it, and within an hour, it was on 20 Russian torrent sites. And it was being downloaded because they released it on iTunes. And it was being actually downloaded at the rate of 20 illegal to one legal. But it wasn't on any Google search engine. So it wasn't Google that was helping those illegal sites. People were going direct to those sites. So we must remember that. If you stop all the Google search engines and all that sort of thing, you will still have people doing piracy, people putting it up there, and people using it. So it is not a silver bullet that just by taking it off a website ranking, you're not going to suddenly take it out. Of course, it's part of the solution. And of course, the next day, it was on Google, and they were doing it 40 to 1 by because it was being signposted. So I accept that that's part of the problem and part of the solution. But we must remember who we should be targeting. It's those who are making profits out of the illegal sites to start with. I always say there's three strands to helping beat piracy. I always say education is the first strand, and we've got to win the hearts and minds of the public, and we haven't done that, and industry, most as much as anyone else, has failed in that. People think it's okay to download, and they don't get why it's so bad. The second thing is what I call the carrots, and that's where industry has to change their models. And we're starting to see that in theatre and so on. And the film industry have done it very well. And we've got to change the model of the carrot. Then we've got the stick, which is the penalties, which comes into the VCAP and so on. And part of the penalties is what I would call is follow the money. And in follow the money, we've got two strands. The first one is where it's a voluntary scheme, where the brand names can take their advertising away from these sites, which is a really good first step, and we're working very hard towards that at the moment. But the next step is much more difficult, and that's to take the tail end of all that advertising, all the porn sites and the casinos who don't care about their reputation, they will advertise on these sites. And there is a third strand to that, and that's where the payment providers have a role to play, the PayPals and the Visas. And I'll give you a good example of why that's important. In Poland, there was a website that had all the future publishing magazines. So for £10, which you paid through Barclaycard, you could take any future publishing magazine you wanted down to your computer. Of course, it was a legal site, but £10 never went to future publishing. But Barclaycard were part of it, they didn't know they were. But we need to stop that. So there's two strands to it. One is through, we think we can do it through money laundering or legislation. The second is through the financial services legislation. And we can actually say that if you're advertising on an illegal site, you're doing something illegal. Now, I'm working with PIPCU, who are the City of London Police Intellectual Property Unit.
Which was set up last year.
Which is a really great unit. And I've actually just asked the Prime Minister to comment on whether because we gave money for 2 years and I'd like it to be on a permanent footing. So I've asked him to do that. And the IPO, which is the IPO. So it's a combination of PIPCO and the IPO. They're like helping me write a report on Follow the Money. And we've got a conference in June where I'm hosting a session for the IPO, an international conference. And I think, as long with the site blocking legislation through the courts, I think that we can be world leaders in this Follow the Money innovative approach. Because if we can choke off the PIPCO reckon that if you can choke off the advertising, you should be able to choke off about 95% of illegal sites, because there will still be some people who will do it because they're just antisocial or whatever, but the vast majority of these want to make money out of it, and if we can stop them making money, it will make a significant impact on piracy. So whilst education, carrots and stick are important, and we should never forget that stick at the end of the day has got to be there, because at the end of the day, if people continue to steal, then you've got to have some way of stopping it. But if we can stop the money as part of all that, we will make a huge step forward. Well, it's a combination of all those, and I think the trouble is in the past everyone thought, well, it should be a government thing doing it, and then the government say it should be an industry thing doing it. And it really is the whole bit, and I'm doing three reports. One is Follow the Money, one's Google, one's on education, and I'm doing that with the PRS for music. And all the industry people I talk to, they signed up to provide people to go out to forums, and I tasked the IPO to find 100 forums in addition to schools that we can actually go out and start spreading the message and have some coordinated approach. There are lots of education programs out there. UK Music do one, the IPO do with the IPO. And there are lots of others, the IP Trust and those sort of people. And all of those matter, but we need to do it on a much bigger scale. And I did this at a university a little while ago. There were 60 people in the audience, and I asked how many were downloading, and they all put their hands up, virtually all of them. And I asked how many of you think you're killing music by doing that, and very few put their hands up. And they were studying music at university. And by the time I finished them, they all realised they were killing the industry. It's not the olden days where you take some music from a vinyl album from a few friends. This is on an industrial scale, and they get. I think you've got to educate all those people, and we haven't done that. If you went out on the street now and asked people, yeah, they'd all be saying, "Yeah, we do it," but they're only rich rock stars. What do they care? We haven't got the message over, and sometimes you have to do it more than just say, well, we're protecting the music industry, which is all the people who are getting the money, and I heard people say that earlier. But I try and equate it that, I mean, we're one of only three countries in the world that is a net exporter of music. I'm sure you know this. I mean, America's the first, Sweden the second, and we're the third, I think. But we do have that money coming in, and it's a £70 billion industry. We employ thousands of people in the industry. If we want a good NHS, it has to be paid for somehow. And if we're not, we can take all those earnings out of the creative industries. I think that we'll have to pay more in taxes or borrowings or whatever. And people sometimes don't get how important the creative industries are to the economy. So we need to take it out there to the average person and say, if you want your grandmother to have an operation down the NHS, don't bitch about it. Stop people downloading. It's part of the jigsaw.
Round of applause there. That's a round of applause.